winter show, we could please bring our voices down. Thank you. Awesome. Okay, so we are so excited to have all of you here to celebrate the end of this first semester with us. We're very, very proud to show what our students have prepared for you. And without further ado, I will pass it off to our MC for the night, Trey Poole.
She deserves a break, and maybe spend a little time with me. You don't even have to give me anything if you bring Graham some teeth. Love, Bernie. Bring any magnetiles for Grace. My mom says we're still paying the plumber and probably putting his kid through college. Whatever that means. You might think I shouldn't have any nine towels either, but I promise I'll put them on the high shelf where Grace can't reach them. And the only other thing I want is a paint set, but that's to say it caused significantly more damage than the manitiles. Your choice, Santa. Thanks and good luck.
Monologue 3, Javon Santadoro, 12th period.
I think you are a fat man and I'm not leaving you any cookies because my mom said Mrs. Santa Claus probably put you on a diet because my mom... You need to stay away from the junk food and don't eat too much on your trip around the world. That's why I'm leaving you vegetables this year with skim milk. I hope you lose some weight because with all those toys in you, I start to feel sorry for Dasher, Dancer, Prancer, Vixen, Comet, Cupid, Donner, and Blitzen. And oh yeah, Rudolph. Mrs. Claus is a busy woman and she can't spend all her time making new red furry clothes for you. So get it together, Santa, and stop getting bigger. Everybody loves good burgers and fries, but moderation, Santa. Moderation. I hope you are happy now doing my part to keep you healthy. Maybe I'll start a Keep Santa Healthy campaign. No cookies for the fat man. I know you will appreciate my hard work one day. Oh, I forgot to mention what I want for Christmas. An easy bake, I would like an easy bake oven. I love fresh cookies right out of the oven. Love you. God.
Jingle Bell Rock, 4th and 5th period.
Robert,
Trey Archer, fifth grade. Dear Santa, I don't want all the other nice things on the list that my dad texted me. I only want a puppy. Every time I think about not getting a puppy, it makes me sadder and sadder. I just want one little puppy. Just one. All I'm asking for is one little puppy. Perhaps a Labrador or a German Shepherd or a Husky. I asked for a puppy last year and I got a gerbil. Not the same. Instead of a month. Not my fault my little brother wanted to give it a hug. The year before that I also asked for a puppy and got a stuffed poodle. I appreciate the thought, but I don't want a poodle, and especially not one that is stuffed. I may just be a kid, but I know the difference between a live puppy and a stuffed animal. Come on, Santa. So this year I'm going to need a puppy, probably not the flower, an official complaint with the North Pole HR department. Thank you. I know kind of that you won't let me down. Love, Trey.
Monologue 5, Haley Cannon, 6th period.
Dear Boss, also known as Santa Claus, I've been working for you for 170 years. I know I'm one of the younger elves in the workshop, but I've been around long enough to notice that the elves never get presents. What's up with that, big man? We work all year long in your workshop and never get to celebrate Christmas ourselves? I like a tree and presents, and it is the season to be jolly. I'd like to dream of white Christmas. All I want for Christmas isn't you, Santa. Would it kill you to throw us a little Christmas party after your trip around the world? Even the Grinch had a party and presents. The Grinch. Are you hearing me, old man? So, on behalf of me and all the other elves, I respectfully request a little respect and a lot of presents. Hold on to your fuzzy red pants, Santa, because we're going to party like it's $29.99.
It's the most wonderful time of the year, 6th and 7th period.
Wonderful time of the year. Dear Santa Claus, this is Campbell again, but I'm writing about my 9-year-old brother Mitchell. Mitch wants a binder hole puncher. I want a hole puncher too. Mitch also wants a skateboard, but don't give the skateboard to him. Mitch is very kind-hearted, but he has a bad temper. He writes messy, doesn't like to read. He needs to work on those things before being awarded. He also wants a Star Wars Death Star, but he is not responsible for his Legos. Our family's island, which jar is full of quarters from our parents, will step it on the Legos when they walk barefooted into his bedroom. Please do not bring any more. The last item on this list is an electric scooter. Does this seem like a good idea to you? A scooter that zooms around the street with a kid who most certainly will not wear a helmet? I know you would make a better decision than that, Santa. If you want my opinion, Mitchell needs Lego storage bin, a binder hole puncher, like I mentioned, some socks, he's always losing one sock, and a jacket, not too expensive because he will lose it. Be careful out there, Santa. Danger is always right around the corner. Bye, Campbell.
Police not be done. Everyone sing along.